Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the slow wave sleep or non-REM sleep. As the individual goes to sleep, he advances from stage 1 to stage 4 of slow wave sleep. These are four stages of progressively deepening sleep. It is difficult to wake up the subject in slow wave sleep, during which EEG pattern becomes progressively slower in frequency and higher in amplitude. The point that you have to remember here in slow wave sleep is EEG pattern becomes progressively slower in frequency and higher in amplitude. As showing in this figure, slow wave sleep is progressively slower in frequency and higher in amplitude. See one by one. This is stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 and stage 4. If you observe all these waves, you can identify that from stage 1 to stage 4, there is a progressively slower in frequency. See here, slower in frequency. And if you observe here, there is a higher in amplitude. See here guys. Amplitude is increasing. Stage 1. First subject becomes drowsy. The EEG shows a change from beta to alpha rhythm. Immediately, light sleep begins, during which the alpha rhythm is replaced by higher frequency and low amplitude EEG waves. Next, coming to the stage 2. The subject then enters into the stage 2 sleep. The amplitude of EEG waves slightly increase in this stage. The hallmark of EEG pattern in stage 2 are sleep spindles and K complexes. The ones that you are remember in stage 2 are sleep spindles and K complex. This is the EEG in stage 1, and next this is the EEG in stage 2. Okay. The key points that you have to remember in stage 2 are sleep spindles and K complex. Okay. Sleep spindles. Sleep spindles are bursts of alpha-like waves having frequency of 12 to 14 hertz and amplitude of about 50 microvolts, each lasting for about 2 seconds. They are called sleep spindles because of the characteristic waxing and waning amplitude. K complexes. K complexes are high amplitude, sharp wave appearing irregularly in EEG. Next, stage 3. This is the stage of moderately deep sleep. The rhythm of the EEG waves shows lower frequency and higher amplitude. Next is stage 4. This is the stage of deep sleep, with delta rhythm predominant over the whole slab. Maximum slowing, we call that lowest frequency with large amplitude waves, is seen in this phase. It is very difficult to wake up the subject in this phase. In young adults, maximum time of sleep is spent in stage 4. Autonomic and other changes during slow wave sleep. Decrease in heart rate and blood pressure, fall in body temperature, slow and regular respiration, increase in gastrointestinal activity, which indicates increased parasympathetic activity, decrease in muscle tone, no rapid eye movement, we call that non-REM stage. Sleep is deep in stage 3 and stage 4. Control mechanism of slow wave sleep. Mechanism controlling slow wave sleep may be broadly classified into neural and chemical mechanism. Okay. First, neural control mechanism. Neural control mechanism of slow wave sleep may be subdivided into three categories: afferent control, central control, circadian control. First, afferent control. It is known that repeated and monotonous stimulation of mechanoreceptors are afferent from these receptors at a frequency less than 10 Hz produces sleep. This is mediated by low frequency stimulation of brainstem and other areas that activates the sleep producing areas in the brain. Next, central control. There are three brain areas that on appropriate stimulation produces slow wave sleep. These sleep zones are diencephalic zone, medullary zone and basal forebrain zone. Next, diencephalic zone. This zone is formed by posterior hypothalamus and intralamellar and anterior thalamic nuclei close to hypothalamus. Low frequency stimulation of this zone produces EEG pattern that resembles slow wave sleep. Next, medullary zone. The reticular formation at the level of nucleo tractus solitarius in medullum constitutes the medullary sleep zone. Low frequency stimulation of this zone produces slow wave sleep. Next, basal forebrain zone. Pre-optic area of hypothalamus and diagonal band of Broca from this zone where stimulation produces slow wave sleep. Next one is circadian control. It was observed in experimental animals. This destruction of suprachiasmatous nucleus disrupts many behavioral and circadian rhythms including the sleep-wake cycle. The suprachiasmatic nucleus is the biological clock which is influenced by light-dark circle through retino-hypothalamic pathway. Thus, day and night variation controls sleep by influencing inherent rhythmic discharge of the biological clock. And the next is chemical control mechanism. Center for mechanism governing non-REM and REM sleep lie in pons, which is influenced by serotonin, norepinephrine, acetylcholine, adenosine and prostaglandins. First, serotonin. It is clearly known that serotonin agonists suppress sleep and serotonin antagonists induce slow wave sleep. Serotonergic projection from raphe nucleus to thalamus and cortex play role in the control of sleep. Norepinephrine. Cells in the locus ceruleus release norepinephrine. Fibers from locus ceruleus project to the spinal cord and also to the cortex. The ascending fibers on stimulation prevent sleep and descending fibers inhibit motor neurons that produce hypotonia during slow wave sleep. Administration of L-DOPA catecholamine precursor causes an increase in wakefulness. Stimulation of the adrenergic fibers of the reticular formation leads to the EEG, aerosol and spinal facilitation. Inhibition of catecholamine synthesis leads to a decrease in EEG aerosol, that is, a move towards the EEG synchronization. Considerable evidence suggests that decrease in brain monoamine causes increase in REM sleep, not slow wave sleep, and vice versa. That means increase in brain monoamine causes decrease in REM sleep or increase in non-REM sleep. Acetylcholine. Cholinergic neurons projecting rostrally from dorsal pontine tegmentum are part of RAS. Acetylcholine secreted from these neurons play a role in the control of sleep. It is proposed that cholinergic mechanisms selectively promote REM sleep. Adenosine. Adenosine induces sleep. Caffeine, which is an antagonist of adenosine, is known to produce alertness. Prostaglandin. Increased concentration of PGD2 in medial preoptic area induces sleep and increased concentration of PGE2 decreases slow wave sleep and produce wakefulness. Okay guys, this is about the slow wave sleep and non-REM sleep. If you like my explanation, please like, share and don't forget to subscribe and don't miss the notifications. Thanks for watching.